It's always nice to get out on site with GSH Electrical. So out with me, good mate, Marcus.
Yeah.
Because you've got some really interesting stuff you found. Some of it is obviously going to be taken out. We'll explain that in the first part of the video.
Yeah.
But some of it can be allowed to be left in, which is quite mind-bending, isn't it?
It is, yeah. And some of the stuff you're going to see, you might think, oh, that's not allowed to be there. But again, I've spoke to my competent person scheme just to get clarity on the situation, because maybe my mindset was leaning towards, oh, can that be there, can't it be them? But when we look at previous editions and stuff, and we can look at that.
Yeah, we can see it in there. Now, as I look to the left-hand side here, Hopefully the cameraman can show it, this has got a little bit of a whiff of orange flex, which in my day was things like the lawn mower and hedge trimmer. Yeah. And it seems quite small. What is it currently feeding?
So it's actually feeding at the minute some appliances in the kitchen. So we've got a cooker. It's actually a gas cooker, however, yeah, it needs a power supply for the ignition and for the clock. It's also feeding a washing machine as well.
So this here, so let's go inside and investigate what that looks like. It seems to get worse in here, Marcus, because see the orange flake. As in, it's just come through here, is it?
Just as
a route through.
Yeah, so short part of the story is the customer rung me to quote because they had this wire,
right,
and they just wanted that wire removing because they didn't like it like this. So
okay,
I actually come around to quote, and the first thing I looked at, and I thought, wait there a minute, we've got a cable in that light switch, it's going to a plug top, I hope it isn't feeding this plug in the actual plug top's live. So first of all, my first when I come to quote is I check that.
Yeah.
And then obviously they said about something in the garage, which we'll get to later on, but yeah, this was actually what the quote was for, just to sort of get rid of this cable. So I obviously had to do some further investigation, and that's when I sort of said to the customer, might be a good idea to have an EICR,
yeah,
a condition report, just to have a look at how things have been done, because you see stuff like that, which the kitchen fitter did, because we all know they're qualified electricians.
Walk the route through, so it comes past the light switch, but doesn't, goes into a plug and extension lead, follows the extension lead, and then is plugged into the socket.
Yes.
So it's sending that supply out on the wall we saw outside,
yep,
okay, come through that route, and then is at a socket up here.
Yes.
But when you got there, how many conductors did you have in it?
Yeah, so there's only two, and again, part of an EICR is looking at the fixed wiring, and maybe we don't necessarily have to worry too much about anything that's on a plug top because it's not part of the fixed wire,
yeah,
of the installation. However, when then I go to test certain points and realise that actually this oven here,
yep,
the washing machine,
yep,
doesn't have a means of connection to earth because that is only a 2-core flex.
Okay, so yeah, so it's feeding the igniter on the oven,
yep,
and obviously the washing machine there is exactly beyond average. However, then when we do a little bit further investigation, that's going to get changed.
Yep.
Okay, we're cool with that. A little bit further investigation is where your competent person scheme comes in, because
yep,
when we look at the socket over here, and when we took off a socket outlet in here, we yep had a lot of cables in there. First yep up, they were all flex, and one of
they
them was
were
enormously long in length, wasn't
yes
it?
Yes, oh, very long. Yeah.
So that first of all question comes up: can you wire final circuits in flex?
Well, again, I was sort of under the pretense of I wasn't 100% sure, to be honest. So this is where I spoke to my competent person scheme, and I said, look, the kitchen, and obviously a massive part of an EICR is the inspection, because if you just plug in to do, let's say, a loop test,
yeah,
you're not going to know what's going on behind it. You might get an absolute perfect reading, and actually there might be some little issues behind it. So I spoke to my competent person scheme, and they sort of explained that we can actually use the flex. The flex is fine. However, they had some recommendations, ferrule the ends to ensure, yeah, a good connection in the terminal. So,
and yeah, I'd love for somebody to put it in the comments if they are an electrician and not studying. If you are studying, you'd have to go back and look at it.
Yeah.
I think it was around about the 16th
about
edition.
16th edition, yeah,
yeah, from memory.
Yeah.
It seems such a long time ago. That was
exactly
even when
yeah
I was starting out,
yeah,
that final circuits could be in flex, even though yeah I think the more mature electrician, which I put myself in category, would
yeah
look at it and go, you can't do that.
Yeah,
can't
yeah
do that.
Yeah,
we can't do that.
It's
yeah
not very good. But when you look at the, you know, sometimes you look at a circuit and it might be wired in a cable you're not so familiar can be used as
yep
a final circuit. However, when you look at how it's been done, then that obviously screams issues to me, because it's obviously been thrown in there. The back box was just loose. It wasn't screwed up
right
at all.
Okay.
We've got a mixture of 2.5mm² flex. And we also have, I believe, the problem is there's no markings on it to ensure the voltage rating and things like that. The size, the white cables do look like a 2.5mm² flex, but
yep
the black maybe hints at 1.5. So,
and what about the 2-core that's
yeah
in
yeah
there?
So we've actually got 2-core here for undercovered light, which was just connected in the back. And I know there's always that argument where we can omit the need of an overcurrent protection device depending on whether the load is actually going to be possibly be able to draw more current than the
yep
cable can carry, which in this case probably not the case. However, I still don't necessarily like to see it when there's better ways to do it. Whether we fit a fuse connection unit under here and downgrade the fuse to suit. But what the customers actually request is if we can just put it on a plug top, because they don't really use it that much. So she will just plug it in when needed.
So we've replaced the two core, what I think probably was maybe a strimmer. Cable that was feeding this area here for the cooker igniter.
And the cooker igniter and the clock, because it's actually a gas oven. So it actually made my job a little bit easier, because it wasn't necessarily an induction hob or anything like that. It was purely gas oven, gas hob.
So. Okay, and then we've got a new circuit coming out here in the plastic conduit, got a 2.5, so principles of an A3 radial,
yes? We're going to put in an A3 radial. We're going to pop into the back of the socket that is existing for the extractor hood. And then what we're going to do is we're actually going to change that socket, just because it's hard to confirm stuff, what's going on in the walls with the condition that it's been installed in. Okay. And we're actually going to put it on a fuse spur. So.
Okay, and that's only when it's finished, that final circuit, so you're going to feed those two items, is it?
Yeah,
picked anything else
100%,
up in the...
100%,
yeah. Ah, right, okay, so that makes logical sense. Now, we've also had a little bit of issue when you talk about the garage, and they got a supply out to there, and it was a little bit average. Shall we take a look at that next?
Yeah.
So single insulated cables there on show, so no protection for those cables, and it just looks like a bit of a lash up. And some sort of isolator there, is that a fuse as well?
Yeah, no, it's actually, it has got fuses inside, it's actually got two fuses. Is it ceramic? Yeah, it's got like a handle on the side to operate, and it's got like a lever system on the inside which connects the incoming power to the bus bar.
So. Okay, and we think that's been picked up maybe down by the kitchen area.
Yes.
Okay, but we have been advised that the lady's gonna lift a the slabs outside in the next 12 months.
Yeah.
So there'll be an opportunity to put a new feed in.
Again, so part of my certification is obviously there's certain limitations where we can't physically check connections that are buried inside a wall. And it does seem like it's been made to a connection in the kitchen and buried inside the wall, because we do have an armoured going into the kitchen area. So what I've explained to the customer is that it's a high recommendation on my certification, upgrading, and then, so she's going to have, she explained to me, the start of next year, she's having all these slabs, she's already booked someone in, she's having all the slabs taken up, she's having a new patio, so it's the perfect time to get in a new feed. And we've upgraded the consuming unit, I've left plenty of spare ways to allow for these things to be undertaken.
It's taking a similar route to what we saw in the plastic on, probably low level. Yeah. Okay, so to overcome that with the power that we have got in here, are you installing a two-way consuming unit or something slightly different?
No, I'm going to do something slightly different. So really all she wants in here is one or two sockets and a light fitting. So rather than her go through the expense of having maybe a consumer unit, we're actually just going to install a couple of fuse spurs. We're going to downgrade one fuse spur to a 3-amp fuse for the light fitting itself, and then we're going to have a 13-amp fuse spur just for the two socket outlets.
Which makes logical sense. Now, as I look out the corner of my eye, I see somebody that looks like they're on work experience in their first half term. So, depending on when people watch this video, we're actually in the October half term of the year in which we shoot it, which means that they've been to college for about 6 weeks, and you've taken this person on to give them a couple of days' experience.
Yeah, just a couple of days' experience. He lives near the property I'm working at, so I thought it was a good opportunity for him to be able to come and maybe start learning some basic hand skills and with his tools. So.
Okay, so we'll have a quick chat with Ben next. Yeah. So those of you familiar with the channel will know I've been working with Ben since he was 15. We worked on his CV and you did a little bit of work experience with me, and we've done some lessons at my house as well. So let's catch up with you. So you're now 16, complete those GCSEs. What are you currently doing?
I'm doing a level 2 electrical installation course at Northampton College.
Okay.
Just finished my first term, so I thought I'd get some work experience during the half term.
Okay, so have you done a health and safety exam?
Yes.
Yeah, you're doing the 2365 City and Guilds qualification. The last person probably ever on the planet to do that. That qualification ends this academic year. And this is different, isn't it? I take it you must have wired some lighting circuits at college. Yeah. What are you finding really challenging at this section here that we've stopped you up on this wall?
Trying to actually get it into the brickwork. It's quite difficult because this is really weak here.
Okay, so the actual the mortar between the bricks is really soft. Yeah, however, just down there where you were clipping earlier on, it was really hard, wasn't it? So how have we overcome that? Because obviously I can see you've used a different technique in order to clip your cables.
We decided to drill a hole and put some wood in it, and then you could be able to put the nail through the wood.
Okay, so we wood plugged it effectively. Drilled the brick, put a piece of wood in, and then we've got an easier fix in, a bit like at college then, a wooden fix in, in order to secure that. What size cable were you wiring your lighting circuits in?
1 millimetre cable.
Yeah, millimetre what?
Squared.
Good answer. And your socket circuit cable?
2.5 millimetre squared.
Good, okay. And then both of those circuits are arranged in what way? We talk about how we would express the arrangement of a circuit.
They're a radial.
They are, so they go out and stop at their final point. So the socket circuit could be a ring, but you've wired this one as a radial, which is really good. So are you enjoying this work experience?
Yeah.
Have you taken plenty of photographs?
Yes.
And have you put them on Instagram?
Not just yet.
No.
I'll wait until I've finished.
Yeah, we've been trying to encourage people people to start their own Instagram page if you've got one as an electrical trainee.
Yeah.
Okay, so we can share that out with other people through a QR code on your CV.
Yeah.
So when you send your CV out, you've got this work experience on there. You're going to get a little written statement from Marcus as well, yeah. All things that we recommend that you do, make sure you make the most of your opportunity when training, and it's only great people like Marcus that allows people like Ben to come out and actually gain that work experience. It's invaluable. And if you want to see how we created the CV, okay, that we did with Ben, check out the video on screen now.